man secretly takes pictures of naked men in a locker room. Isn't that against the law? The surprising answer on A Second Look, Sunday after the 10 o'clock news.
Driven deep into left field, back is Anderson at the wall. 2-0 Giants. Home run, Sean Dunston.
Well, good evening, everybody. I'm Mark Ibanez. Bip Roberts is here, and I'll tell you what, if you live and breathe baseball as a fan or as a player or anything in connection with the game, you know by now it can break your heart. But the good news for the Giants is, despite this just tantalizer, this teaser so close to winning the World Championship, they are alive. And Bip Roberts, you played in the major leagues for 12 years. You were in a Game 7 with the Cleveland Indians. You know all about the emotion. Just tell me what we're in for. I mean, what next for Giant fans and for the Giant players, Bip?
Well, I tell you, if you thought today was bad, you wait until tomorrow. Game 7 can just actually put you in the hospital because there's going to be so many feelings, so many emotions going. I mean, it's one of those situations where you hope the Giants come out ahead. If they don't, I don't know what to say around here. We'll have to check a lot of people into the hospital.
All right, there definitely will be a Game 7. The Giants are still alive down in Anaheim. Joe Fonzi to not only relive what we just experienced, but also to help set us up for what will come tomorrow as far as pitching matchups, et cetera, and the emotion. Joe Fonzi, go ahead from Anaheim.
Hey, guys, I don't know. My ears are still ringing from the thunder sticks, but, you know, I'm sure the people at the network love it that they're getting a Game 7, and I suppose if you're always dreaming about playing in the World Series, they always say, you know, all the heroic things happen in Game 7 of the World Series, but I guarantee you for long-suffering Giant fans, they're not looking forward to a Game 7. This has been a series of momentum. The Giants had it first. The Angels had it. The Giants took it back. No question about the fact that the Angels have it now. So it all comes down to one game. You know, let's see how it works out tomorrow. I think one thing that you have to kind of account for at this point is the fact that both bullpens are pretty shot. Francisco Rodriguez pitched quite a while today. The Giants went through their A-list in the bullpen, but don't forget that there are going to be lots of starters who are available to come out of the bullpen tomorrow as well. Let's bring in Russ Ortiz right now, Giants starter who pitched so well tonight. And Russ, I guess in terms of disappointments, they don't come any greater than this, but the silver lining is the fact that you guys have another game to try and get them tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll just, you know, let's try to pick up from this, and, you know, we've always kept our heads up, and that's, you know, what we'll do tonight, and let's come back tomorrow and let's try to finish it out.
Tell us about your effort. I mean, you're in the biggest ball game of your life, and you come up big time. There's no question about it. You seem like you really had your rhythm. You had everything going for you tonight.
Yeah, I was just trying to make my pitches, just trying to execute everything and keep them off balance. And, you know, they hit a couple balls hard that were deep, but for the most part, just try to keep the ball down and not let it hit the fat part of the bat. And so, you know, I'm just happy I was able to bounce back from the last outing.
This is a crazy game, you know, when you think about the 180-degree turn that emotions can take when you guys are in the seventh inning and it's a 5-0 game and it looks for all the world like the Giants are very close to a World Series championship and they make a tremendous comeback and all of a sudden win the game. What goes through your mind, the emotional flip-flop that's going on in the dugout among the players?
I think, you know, when they got three runs in the seventh inning that, you know, we still felt like we were going to win the ball game and, you know, it just didn't work out. You know, they're a very good hitting team. They've proved that this whole year and this whole postseason. So, you know, they just made things happen.
And I guess tomorrow, everybody who probably you're the only pitcher who wouldn't be available to go tomorrow if needed, huh?
Probably. You never know. You know, it's the last game, and you know, we'll see. I mean, I doubt it. I've never done that before, but you know, I think we have plenty of guys that can come in if need be.
Yeah, you'd even crank it up if you needed to get a couple outs tomorrow, huh?
No, you got to do whatever you can. And so, you know, but like I said, you know, I think we have plenty of healthy arms to come in and do the job if we need to. But hopefully we won't have to worry about that.
Well, this has been a series of momentum swings. Good luck to you guys in turning it around the other way again tomorrow. And congratulations to you on a great effort tonight.
Thanks.
All right, Giants starting pitcher tonight, Russ Ortiz. Let's go back to San Francisco.
All right, thanks, Joe. Great effort by Russ Ortiz. 6 1/3 innings. He gives up only 4 hits, 2 earned runs, and you got to hand it to him. I mean, he was outstanding. You figure you turn it over to the aces of the bullpen, it's going to happen. But one thing's for sure, you really can't get on Worrell or Rob Ned. I mean, they have been magnificent in the postseason, and of course, they wouldn't be in the postseason without the job that they do during the regular season. So it's really hard to sit here and criticize what happened to them in the latter half of this ball game.
Well, that's just part of the game. Anytime you have guys going out there and they've been perfect, you know, they're in for a situation where they're not going to be perfect. And that happened tonight. They made a couple mistakes. The Angels, who were down, they got back up in that game because of a couple hits. They were able to play and win this ball game tonight.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to give the opposition credit. That's been the Angels' MO all year. They come back. They've had more than 40 comeback victories all told, and 7 of them in the postseason. So that's what they do, and they did it tonight. But the Giants are still alive, got a game 7. And we got the early stages of this ball game to review as we press play and go on some of the highlights that took us into those fateful last moments. Early on, it was kind of all about the pitching. Kevin Apier, who was lit up in game 2, but he had his thing going early. Down goes Reggie Sanders. What was the difference that you saw, Bip, between the Apier of last Sunday and tonight?
Fastball was down and the slider was down. Had more bite to it tonight. It didn't hang in the zone for the guys to hit it. It had a sharp bite down. Guys were swinging right over it.
And as we mentioned, outstanding efforts by Russ Ortiz. Tonight, he's matching Apier 0-for-0. Didn't make it out of the second inning last Sunday. Different story today. Adam Kennedy gone. What was the difference for Russ today?
Cutter was working, changeup working, fastball working. He had location, was very sharp, and he was in control all night.
All right, and as we go through the first third of this ball game, base runners hard to come by. Giants here in the fourth inning have Berry aboard with, guess what, a walk. Benito hit it on the button, but Troy Glaus starts an around-the-horn double play. No threat happening there for San Francisco.
Well, Troy Glaus made a nice play. As you see right here, the ball's hit hard. It takes a funny bounce at the end, but he has real soft hands. He's able to start the double play, and Kennedy finishes.
Yeah, everybody's going to remember his game-winning double, but the guy had some nice work defensively twice in this ball game at least. But the Giants capable of making some nice defensive plays themselves. Rich Aurelia almost makes the great play right there on Tim Salmon, but the throw not quite in time, and the Angels are thinking maybe they'll get on the board first, but it wasn't going to work.
Well, Richie, he went over there and made a nice play. He got up and tried to make a strong throw. It's in the dirt, and JT Snow, if he can't catch it, it can't be caught.
Yeah, and it's to his backhand side, and the hop, not long, not short, but a tweener, and the toughest play for a first baseman to make. And the Angels have a man on, and they're in business with Garrett Anderson at the plate, but he smacks it right to Jeff Kent. Quick hands, 4-6-3, double play. End of story for the Angels right there, and we move on to the fifth inning. David Bell didn't hit it hard against Apier, but you know what? It's going to work up the middle as that pesky shortstop. There's David Eckstein. Can't quite make the play. Base hit, and the Giants get it going. And then the American League's designated hitter rule backfired on the Angels as the Giants DH Sean Dunston deep to left. 2-run homer, and the Giants into the early lead. 2-0.
Well, Sean, right in that situation, hadn't had a home run in a couple months. Catches a slider inside from Kevin Apier, puts the bat on the ball, and just barely gets it out of the yard.
And, you know, you had to be thinking, I mean, if Sean Dunston, who has gone through a whole lot of struggles offensively this year, he comes on and hits one, you figure it's the Giants' year. And it continued in that inning as Kevin Apier comes unglued a little bit. Kenny Lofton high and deep to right center and up against the boards. You know that's extra bases. And going ape is Apier in the dugout, destroying all kinds of stuff. And you said later he'd probably tear up the clubhouse. And then it'll be Kenny Lofton stealing third and then coming home on a wild pitch. And there you go. It's that K-Rod guy, and they were able to get to him tonight.
Well, you see right there, Molina tries to backhand a ball in the dirt. That's mechanically unsound, and so it gives Kenny Lofton an opportunity to score.
Kevin Apier's not liking it. Francisco Rodriguez was invincible tonight. He's looked pretty unhittable early in this series, but the Giants got to him the other night at Pac Bell for a winning run, and then tonight they scored upon him. But Giants off to the early lead, but we'll tell you what happened when we continue with the extra inning. Joe Fonzi standing by with some post-game interviews and also the setup for tomorrow's ultimate, the Game 7. We're coming back with more on the extra inning.
6-3 to end the inning. And a race to